I am Bishop Sanctus Lino Wanok, the Bishop of Lira Diocese. This diocese takes the whole of Lang sub-region. Before COVID, the main thing which engulfed the world, the whole world was becoming just a political world where war is being staged, people are killing themselves, an environment was being destroyed, and all the instrument that human beings could make was becoming even very destructive. Now, there are a lot of protests all over the world against our political leaders, and some even have turned religion to become very political. And there are a lot of quarrels among humanity. You wonder what human being wants. And we were highly surprised by COVID. And it was as if God is saying, hey, what are you doing? Where are you going? What is going on in the world? Why are you disturbed? And imagine this particular COVID found the people were moving all over the world. People are moving everywhere, and people are going for tourism, for what? But people were not caring anything about God. They care less about the word of God. They took the world in their hands, and a few, especially poor people, the most exploited people, seem to be the one who cares about praying and so on. And still, the prayer seemed not to be very effective because the world was a little scared. Now COVID came and put a stop of the whole thing. All the movement, socially, people felt that the world was one family. And this took us, it is a 2 years of a very painful moment. And yet, on the other hand of the environment, at least the big forests which were being depleted and so on, the big factories of the world powers came to a standstill. A bit of improvement about the world also took place. So the dilemma is now, what is the human activity all about? And is it really to make us live a better life, or it is all about human exploitation? Is politics really to govern the world for a better world or for selfish desire of a few? But the main issue here is, will people remember the reason why they are created? Why do we exist in this world? Where are we going? Why are we having these social interactions where our movement is very important, where we can realize that we are one family, where love should reign among us? Much as we regret what has happened to the world and too much death has happened in the world, on the other hand, you see, the way God is trying to teach us, maybe a few more people will come together and see why they should pray and see why we need each other and see why we should improve our politics, practice good politics, so that it is inclusive, not exclusive, so that people begin to love one another and care for good governance, where everybody matters, every human being matters. So the new year, as we are ending it now, is really trying to pinpoint this socially. Have we improved the way we look at each other, the way we live at home, the way we care for one another and the property of one another, so that one must live so that I may also live. One must have a good life so that I may also have a good life. The balance of life is at stake, is really being questioned. And the greed of politics, as for us in Uganda, I think this should teach us a lot in Uganda and even everywhere. You see in the whole world, if you can, you only need to turn the television and see the protests all over, the killing, the war. Everything is really in turmoil. So people are calling for a caring world, a world that matters for everybody, and the rights and duties of everybody is promoted. And as we embrace it, and as we are going for the new year, and as the economies are opening, we should not go back to the old way of destruction. We should come now to the new life, where we try to make sure that we promote life for every human being. Every business must be life promoting. Every political world must promote life. Every environment must be cared for, because this is our home. And then everybody must be concerned, must be aware why our home we need to care. For example, now people should not, for example, this year burn grasses. Grass should not be burned as it used to be, because things have changed and God is teaching us slowly so that we may begin to be aware of our duty of caring for the world, as it is in Genesis chapter 2, verse 15. Care for the world and promoting it, so that this becomes part of our human, you know, responsibility together. Whether you are white, you are black, you are Indian, you are colored, you are what, we are the same. And that's the lesson which this virus has taught the whole world. We are just human beings with the same feeling, with the same reaction. And if we don't care for one another, we are going to die also together. So there is no one who can say, if those ones in China are dying, Africa will be safe. Never. Now we have learned a big lesson. And if Americans are vaccinating, they should not think that they should exclude Africa, or the Oceanians should not be vaccinated, because their problem is the problem of humanity in America. So we have learned a big lesson, and we hope we are all grasping this, and we want to put this in prayer during this Christmas. And I ask all the children who are there and who have grown at home, don't say you are grown up now, I cannot go to P1. You go back and begin where God wanted you to start. And all the religious leaders, we must accept that we ask all our followers to go and be jabbed. They must be inoculated. And it is unfortunate some people are using religion as politics. That's where, and then you begin to reject things, you begin to try to care only for yourself, and begin to raise a very call for hope, which does not sustain humanity. So we call for all those who have not vaccinated themselves, let them come up and get vaccinated. So what we want is life, because Jesus said, I have come to give life and give it to the full for each and every one. And that is in John chapter 10, verse 10. A thief comes to destroy and rob and try to steal people and grab things of others, destroy environment for the selfish end, which we are suffering from, and we have suffered enough. So COVID has taught us a lesson, and let us embrace it in a new way in the new year. Thank you very much. May God bless you.